Hi everyone, welcome you all. So in the today's video, I'm going to show you how we can parse JSON response and how we can validate. So I'm taking the help of Store API, so which is basically designed for e-commerce applications. And when I hit this API, get request, and which will return all the products which are available in the database. And every product is having certain attributes, like every product having ID, title, price, description, category, and image, rating, and so on. So like this, every product, you can see certain number of attributes which are available, and which is written the all the products information which are available in the database. So now let us see how we can parse this particular JSON response and how we can validate the data from the specific fields or specific attributes in the response. So now let me connect to the VS Code editor. And this is my Cypress automation, which is a Cypress project folder. And inside this API testing, I'm going to create new file. Now I'll name it as parsing JSON response, right? So parsing JSON response dot cy dot js. So now I'm creating the block. So we'll say first we start with the describe block. And inside the describe block, we have to pass two parameters. So one is, I can say API, or you can say parsing response, basically JSON response, parsing JSON response. And the second parameter is arrow function, which we are going to implement. Fine. So now I'm going to write one it block inside this describe. So for that, I'm going to write one more it block. And the description is parsing simple JSON response. So first I'll show you how we can parse simple JSON response, and then we will see complex JSON. So parsing simple JSON response, and again arrow function, and this arrow function we have to implement. Fine. So what type of request we have to send? So here we have to send get request, and with this particular URL, and then we'll get some response. Now let us send the request. So by calling cy.request, we can send the request. So inside this, we need to specify what kind of request we have to send. In the curly brace, we have to specify the what type of request method is, that is get request. So in the single quotation, we have to specify comma, then URL. So URL we have to specify. Now go to the Postman tool, and this is a URL. Now I'm sending the URL in the double quotation, and which will return all the products from the database. And then, so sometimes if you want to pass any query parameters, we can use QS is a parameter, then we can filter this also. So currently this API returns all the products, but still if you want to filter it, you can limit it. So that I will show you the next. So for now, this is a simple method, which is get request and URL I'm sending. And this is got closing. So this request method is got closed. Fine. So once it is request is sent, then what we need to validate. So we need to capture the response. So response. Okay. And so in the response, what we need to validate. So we need to extract all the attributes one by one. So what are the exact attributes we want to verify, that we need to first check it. So before that, we need to check the status code. So how we can verify the status code? By using assertion. I say expect. So response dot status code or status response dot status 2 dot equals. You can use EQ method equal or whatever. So multiple methods are there. So this is a 200 is a status code. Now along with this, I want to verify the JSON response. Now if you go back to the request, so this is a JSON response. So before parsing this JSON response, we need to understand what is exact structure. And by using JSON path, we can extract a specific value of the particular attribute. So here we need to depend on JSON path. Okay, we need to properly write a proper JSON path, and then we will able to extract the data. Okay, so let me get this response in the JSON format. So currently it's a JSON format. And if you don't know how to write a JSON path, there are so many tools are available. You can automatically generate the JSON path for the particular field. So the most popular website which is available, JSON Path Finder. So if I go to this particular website and whatever response you capture, you can just paste it over here. This is the whole response you got it from the API request, right? So now whichever field or attribute you want to locate in this particular JSON response, you need to properly write a JSON path. But before that, we need to first understand this. If you look at this, this is basically a JSON body. So this whole thing is a JSON body. And each and every record, so from here to here, this is one object, a JSON object. And this is another JSON object. And this is another JSON object. So all these JSON objects are present inside the JSON array. So actual data is a JSON body started with a JSON array. So which contains the JSON objects. Now, sometimes this JSON object is also contains another object, rating, which contains the two attributes and field. Right, so which is basically a JSON array which contains a multiple JSON objects, and again every JSON object is having some other child object. So that we need to understand first. Now based on this, we can write our path. So for example, if I look at here, as soon as you put this all response, so if I just go back to the zero, because the first object in this array is represented with a zero index. So if I go back to the zero, it will show you the attribute along with the value. So ID equal to one, title, price, and description, category, image, rating, and so on. This is all belongs to first object in the array. Okay. And it is automatically generating the JSON path. Suppose I want to capture the title of this product. If I select this, this is automatically generated. So basically X of zero is representing JSON body. So once I extracted the body, and from there we can capture the title. Okay, so let me just go back to the Cypress now. So by writing the JSON path, we can extract the data. So now I want to validate, or let us take the first object. In the first object, I want to validate the title. In the first object, I want to validate the title. So how we can extract this attribute is by writing the JSON path properly. Now, let me write the JSON path. So expect, and from the response, we have to extract the body. So response dot body, we have to extract. So again, body is having multiple attributes. The JSON array itself is a body. So we need to extract the first object, say zero object. In the zero object, there are multiple fields are there, ID, title, price, and so on. So I want to capture the title first. So body of zero dot ID, and that I want to compare with my expected. I say two dot equal, and the value is expected is one. Similarly, we can also validate other fields of zero object. So let's say I want to verify title. So this is the title of the product, and you can specify here, this is the title of the product, because this is a string, we have to keep in the double quotations. And similarly, I want to verify the price also. Price. Now we can just verify title and the price. So what is the value? 109.95. 109.95. Right. So like this, we can put multiple validations on the JSON response. So this will exactly validate the first object, that is a zero object. ID, title, prices are exactly same or not. It will validate. Okay. So suppose this JSON object is also having some child object here. Now in the child object, I want to validate a rating. So this particular rate attribute value, I want to validate. Now from the zero record, we want to navigate to the rating. Inside the rating, we have a rate. So how we can validate that? We can simply write like this. Expect json.body.0. Here, instead of price, what is an attribute here? Rating, that we need to specify. Rating. And inside the rating, we have a rate. That also we need to specify. Rating dot rate. And that value of rating is what? 3.9. That we need to specify. 3.9. So like this, we can validate specific data from the JSON response by writing proper JSON path. Okay. Now, let us try to execute this first. And later, we will also validate some more records. So first of all, let us try to execute this it block. So for that, first of all, I'm saving the file. Now open the terminal. So inside the terminal, I'll specify the command npx cypress, and I'm directly running through terminal, or if you want to run through Cypress app, we can still run it. NPS Cypress run hyphen hyphen spec, and here we can specify the relative path of that particular spec file. So this is how we can directly run through terminal. So now we execute. Okay, now it is successfully executed and my test is got passed. So if you still want to run through Cypress app, what we can do is we can simply open the application. Let me clear this. And you can say npx cypress open. So this command will open Cypress application. Now go to end-to-end testing, select the Electron browser. Now here it will show you all the spec files. Now whichever spec file you want to just execute, you can just click on this parsing JSON response. So now it is successfully executed. Now we can see all assertions are successfully passed. Okay, this is how we can do it. Okay, suppose I just want to validate some other objects in the same response. So currently I have validated the zero object, the first object in the JSON array. Okay, now suppose I want to validate totally how many are there. So totally 20 objects are there. Now I want to validate something in the 20th object. Okay, 20th object I want to validate. So then what we can do is we can simply change the index. So same thing, you can just copy. And now if you want to validate something in the 20th record, you can just pass the index number. So 20th record number means what? We need to capture the proper index because it will start from zero. This will be obviously 19, right? So if I just go to the JSON pathfinder and go back to the last one, 19th, this is actually 19th one. Okay, so that index we have to pass. Now go back to the VS Code editor. Now I'll just change the 19 like this ID. So ID should be what here? 20 we are expecting. ID should be 20. So status code we already validated, so we can just remove this. Okay, so the 20th record ID will be 20. Now this is also 19 is an index of that particular object. Okay, now I can say like this. So title, so what is the title of the 20th recording? So this is the title of the 20th record or 20th object. So that I can specify here. This is the title and what is the next price? So what is the price here? 12.99. So 12.99. So this is the price. And then rating is what? 3.6. So here 3.6. Right. So like this, we can write a proper JSON path and then we will able to test it. So let me run this and check the output in the Cypress app. Okay, go to the file and then save it. Okay, so it is still running on my Cypress app. Let me open my Cypress app. Not this one. Okay, so this is Cypress app. I'm just rerunning this again. So now all my test cases or tests are passed. You can see this is the 20th record, 20th object from the same JSON response. Okay, so this is how we can simply parse a JSON file, and by writing proper JSON response, we can extract the data and then we can validate it. Okay, so if you have a simple JSON response, you can do like this, but sometimes you may get some complex JSON as a response. And in that case, what we need to do is we need to traverse throughout the JSON response, right? So there are multiple fields are there. So for every object, there are different fields are there, like title is there for every object, price is there for every object, right? So suppose I want to capture titles of all the objects, or I want to capture only prices from all the objects. So I want to check the ratings of every object, multiple objects ratings I want to verify. Let's say you have 50 objects or 20 objects we have in this response, right? It will be very complex JSON. So in that case, what we can do is we need to traverse or we need to parse the whole JSON response. And whatever the data we want to retrieve only that particular data from the response, and then we can apply the assertions on that particular data. Okay. And that is possible by writing the loop. We have to iterate the each and every object in the JSON array. Then whatever the data we want from this response, we can capture the data and we can apply the validations. Now, let us see how we can validate the huge JSON response. Let us assume which contains almost 20 records. Now, my requirement here is I just want to find price of every product. So every product is having price. So first of all, I want to retrieve the price for every product. And finally, I want to find the total price of all the products. Okay, I will find the total value of the all the products, and then I will compare the total value with my expected value. So that's my requirement and validation. So how we can achieve this? So in this case, it is we are not actually getting the only one attribute from one object. We want to get the price value from all the objects, whichever is available. And we need to find out the total of all the objects. Okay, that is our expectation. Fine. So now how we can achieve this? Now let me write another test for writing, for getting the prices for all the products. So same it block. I'm just going to copy this. So this time, parsing or complex JSON response. And this time I'm going to execute only this particular it block. Now everything is same. So cby.request method is equal to get URL. And this time there are 20 records are there. So if you want to limit, you can limit, because I did not count the total price of all 20 records in the JSON array. So let us try to limit this. Okay. So what I'll do is I can just apply the limit here. So limit in the sense we can just add another query parameter to this. So I have another request here, limit results. So the same request, only thing is we need to apply one query parameter, limit equal to 5. So this will able to return only 5 records from the database. Okay. So now what I'll do is I will apply the limit for this URL. That is a query parameter I will pass. So how we can pass query parameter? You can say QS. QS and in the curly braces, we can specify query parameter. What is the parameter? Limit equal to 5. Limit colon 5. So this is my query parameter. So this time, this request will return only 5 records. Now I will find the total price of all the products. Every product is all 5 products are having prices. So I want to capture each and every price from every product. Then I will find out the total. Then I will apply the assertion. So that's my expectation. So let us remove all these things we don't need, because we don't need, we no need to capture each and every attribute value here. We want to work on the only price attribute for all the products. Okay. Now, so first let us check the response is 200 or not. And then, so we need to write a loop. So through which we will able to capture everything. So after getting the response, after capturing this, what we need to do? Okay, we verify the status code is 200. Then, so from the response, we have to first extract response body, because we want to traverse through response body. Response contains so many other fields also. Response contains a response body, response contains a status code, and response contains a headers, cookies, so much of information which contains. No, we don't need all that information. We need only response body, so that we will traverse through response body. So as soon as you verify the status code, so here from that response, I want to capture the body first. So response, taking the same variable, response dot body. Okay, now I capture the body. So this body contains what? There are multiple objects are there. So in the previous request, from the body only we have accessed 0 record, first record, second, third, fourth, up to 20 objects are there in the body. So by passing index, we are able to capture. Similarly, here we have to write a loop. So through which we will able to repeat each and every object multiple times. We will iterate through the objects. So here body dot, we use something called for each loop. Okay, for each. And from the object, whatever the body we capture from the body, each and every object we are retrieving and storing into element. Let us say first object we have retrieved, storing into the element. So what this element is representing? This element is representing the object in the JSON array. From this, we have to capture the price element. How can I capture element dot? Only price attribute we need. So price. And that we need to add. So we need to take a temporary variable. So before starting this it block, I will create one variable. Let total price equal to 0. Total price equal to 0. Now here, as soon as we capture that price, I will add that into the total price. So total price equal to total price plus element dot price. Okay, so whatever variable we define here, in every iteration, we will capture the price from every object, and that price we are adding to the total price. So once this is completed, once the then block is completed, so then we will get the total price into this variable. So now we can add one assertion. So what is an assertion we can add? Expect total price. Total price. And what is the total price we are expecting? To equal. And if you are taking only 5 records limit, and I already calculated. So if you are taking only 5 records, 5 objects, and the total price will be something like, say, 899.23. So let us cross check this again. So this is the assertion. So we captured the total price and we are comparing with the actual total price. This is for, I calculated for 5 objects, for limit 5. But if you print the objects, like if you are printing all the 20 objects in the response, then the total price will be different. Okay, that you need to calculate before, and accordingly you can specify the expected value. So this is how we can simply parse the response, and whatever the data we want from the response, we can get it by writing the loop, and then we can apply the validation point. Okay, now let us try to save this file, and then I will execute one more time. So go to the terminal, new terminal, and I'm trying to open the Cypress app again. NPX Cypress open. So this will open our Cypress application, end-to-end testing and Electron browser. Now I'm trying to execute this parsing JSON response. Perfect. Now we can see its status code is 200. And for the 5 records of limit, 899.23 is our expected and equal to same, exactly matching. Fine. So now what I'll do is I will try to change the limit. Okay. So here limit is 5, right? So let us make it as a 3. And when I say limit equal to 3, obviously this value will change. So I will also change this expected value. So if you have only 3 records, so that total value will be around 188.24. So I can say 188.24. This is the value. So this is the total value for first 3 records, limit 3. Okay, because I have applied the query parameter here. Fine, save the file and then go back to the Cypress, and now perfectly executed. So same, whatever we are expecting, it is exactly matching. Okay, so this is how we can simply parse JSON response, and whatever data we want to extract from it, we can extract and we can apply the validations on the JSON response. It can be complex sometimes. So even though it is a very complex, still we will able to capture the data by writing proper JSON path. And whatever data we want to capture, we can capture it, and we apply some validations by using assertions. Okay, so this is how simply we can parse JSON data in Cypress. Okay, so that's all for this video. So thanks for watching. We'll see the next concept in the next video.